Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel. And in the video today, we're looking at why beans give you gas. It's the job of your digestive system to break down the foods you take in, allowing the nutrients to cross over into the different body systems and organs for use as fuel. Each different part breaks down these foods differently. For example, the mouth chews it up into smaller parts, and the stomach uses enzymes and acids to further break it down. The food then goes to the small intestine, where most of the nutrients that come from our food, proteins, fats, and carbohydrates, get absorbed into the bloodstream by a process called diffusion. What is left is then passed to the large intestine, whose main job is the absorption of water that remains in the indigestible residue of the food. A further role of the large intestine is to break down polysaccharides, fiber, that get passed into it. One type of fiber prevalent in beans is oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharides are basically sugar molecules that are made up of several different types of monosaccharides, usually 2 to 10 of them, to form a polymer. An enzyme that would break down these molecules does not exist anywhere inside the human body. Therefore, when they pass into the large intestine, they serve as food for the countless microbes present. While the microbes are processing these substances, they release several different types of gases, mainly hydrogen, nitrogen, and carbon dioxide. Don't be concerned about these particular gases, they are absolutely stench-free. Your fetid flatulence affliction is from a rather different source. Specifically, about 1/3 of the microbes end up producing methane as a result of breaking down these sugars. Once the methane builds up to the point that it begins to produce pressure on your anal sphincter, that's when the rather smelly magic does happen. Microbes breaking down these otherwise indigestible substances is important for our health, as one of the byproducts of this is the creation of various vitamins that get absorbed into the body, as well as for the production of antibodies that help fight off certain types of infections. The downside is that the gaseous side effects of these bacterial processes tends to clear rooms everywhere. You might have resigned yourself to the fact that you can never eat beans before going on a first date, but fret not, there are some methods to prevent your noxious abdominal expulsions. For instance, there is a type of mold called Aspergillus niger that contains an enzyme, Alpha-Galactosidase, that will break down oligosaccharides, preventing your large intestinal bacteria from creating gas. You can buy it at stores everywhere under the auspicious name Beano. If you don't want to be seen sprinkling your beans with this product, you can always try soaking your beans in water for several hours before you make your food. This softens the beans and allows them to ferment. The yeast produced can consume the offending oligosaccharides and help leave your dinner date vapor-free. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, over there on the right are a couple of other videos that you might enjoy if you enjoyed this one, and thank you for watching.